halfway of finishing this Marvel Universe countdown to Avengers Infinity War, getting ever so closer and closer. Today, I'm going to be reviewing the second-to-last Marvel movie from Phase 2 of the Cinematic Universe, Thor: The Dark World. In ancient times, the gods of Asgard fought and won a war against an evil race known as the Dark Elves. Their survivors were neutralized, and their ultimate weapon, the Aether, was buried in a secret location. Hundreds of years later, Jane Foster finds the Aether and becomes a toast, forcing Thor to bring her to Asgard before Dark Elf Malekith, played by Christopher Eccleston, captures her and uses the weapon to destroy the Nine Realms, including Earth. Sounds super intense. Come to think of it, this sequel is a lot more intense than the last Thor movie. Not saying it's bad, not saying it's unperformed or anything. What I'm saying is this sequel is a lot more intriguing and action-packed than last time. I mean, the first movie was just fun and getting to know the characters, but this movie, on the other hand, dives into the plot and story a lot more. I mean, just when the movie started, right away, it almost feels like Lord of the Rings. If you saw Lord of the Rings, you'll see why. Anyways, it dives into the plot of an evil race that is spreading a red glitter of darkness that consumes pain and control inside a human body to protect itself from being destroyed. That's some intriguing and well-executed storytelling, if I do say so myself. Anyways, the CGI when it comes to showing us other worlds in this universe still never ceases to amaze me. Each time a character visits an unknown world in this movie, the CG effects around them felt so vast and complex that I cannot get enough of it. It almost feels like I've been transported into space, although Asgard is in space as well. But it still doesn't make it terrible. It's an awesome feeling to have when you're watching a movie like this. It sucks you in and you can't escape from it. In short, I love the CG in this film. Also, the camera work and cinematography when it comes to action fight scenes are so exhilarating. The action sequences as a whole are fun to watch. I don't care what anybody says about this movie. Sure, the final climax of this film can get a little long-winded and confusing, but you still roll with it just because of how fun this movie is. Now, Kenneth Branagh did not direct this Thor movie, but still, even though Alan Taylor took over directing this film, he still did a great job doing it. Chris Hemsworth and Natalie Portman still did awesome in this movie. So did Tom Hiddleston. Tom Hiddleston as Loki, he cracks me up sometimes. Like in one scene in this film where all the guards are fighting the prisoners in the dungeon, in his own cell, he's just chilling in the corner reading a book and is all like, yeah, don't mind me, I'll just hang out here, keep punching and kicking each other, I don't care who dies or not, I'm just gonna chillax for a bit, enjoying myself. That was great, I love it. As for the character development articulation, only one word. Relatable. You still get to interact with the characters in various peril-inducing situations. Yeah, sure, it's not entirely important in other movies, but for this one, it's really easy to interact with the characters and getting to know what they're planning and how they're gonna work together to destroy an evil disease that's spreading into other worlds, including ours. That's what's intriguing about this movie. In short, in the end, Thor: The Dark World may not be as perfect as any other Marvel Universe film out there, but it's still a whole lot of fun with an interesting story, great characters, and exciting action. So as a result, I rate Thor: The Dark World 5 out of 5 stars. Steve Rogers, looks like you need my help with S.H.I.E.L.D. Stay tuned. So Thor: The Dark World, have you seen it? If you haven't, let me know in the comments which Thor movie is your most favorite. Thor Ragnarok counts, just saying. But if you have, come back and let me know what you thought about it. Also, if you like this video and you want to see some more, make sure that like button shines in your face. That'll totally help me out a ton. Also, share that video with your family and friends and favorite it. That's a very good way to show support for this review. Also, if you're new to my channel, make sure to subscribe and ring that bell right next to you so you can be notified of future videos that I have in store for you. But until then, I'll see you next time. Peace out.